gems, kind of think they get, and then they get those brilliant, those pretty ass flowers, but it takes a while for the fruit. I guess because you get such a big fruit. Like pumpkins are big, and watermelons are big, squashes come out big.
Tell me what sparked it. You all a young man. Mm-hmm. I am a country, an old country woman. And we know gardening.
Uh-huh.
What sparked your interest in creating this beautiful?
I mean, that same idea. Basically maintaining that legacy. We wanted to garden a little bit. Like, I own this home, and I wanted to garden a little bit and teach my daughter.
Awesome.
So I asked one of our elders. He was from Mississippi or Louisiana. And he said the same thing. Like, he grew up on it, so he taught us how to do it. And after that first year and that experience, we loved it. So we turned this into a community garden.
Okay.
Yeah, we went around for like the last year. We visited community and urban gardens around the country, from Phoenix to Denver, Texas. And we loved the idea. And we realized that Virginia State was a food desert. I mean, Virginia State, that Virginia, Petersburg was a food
desert.
Right,
absolutely.
So anyway, she's like, oh, I went to the choir, there was just so much smoke and marijuana and smoke and stuff. And
they removed the gazebo. Where is that? Oh, come on. What up? She's one of the main characters.
Oh, I love you. Thank you so much. Yeah, there's a lot of energy in it.
It grabbed me. Y'all gonna help us in the garden today?
Yeah!
We're gonna go to Moe's.
I don't know when I'm supposed to, you know, what it's supposed to do. What is this?
It's, see, that's red romaine, that's red leaf lettuce.
I spray them. Now, one thing, I got a water hose, and I spray it.
Man, well, I appreciate y'all, man. If y'all want some to eat, man, come on in. You know I got you.
Oh, that's love.
All right, man. All right now.